Good morning, everyone. For your information, today's agenda will be opening ceremony, Mae Fah Luang University's video presentation, report for opening ceremony by Assistant Professor Dr. Panupong Jaiwut, Vice President of Mae Fah Luang University, welcoming speech and opening activities by Assistant Professor Dr. Machima Naradison, President of Mae Fah Luang University. Introduction related to departments, the Office of Postgraduate Studies, the Division of Registrar, the Learning Resources and Educational Media Center, and the last will be the Global Relations Division. Thank you. Hello everyone, please turn on your camera for we are going to start the ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the new graduate student orientation for the academic year 2023. I'm honored to serve as a guest speaker and my name is Mr. Sokupor. Our aim is to warmly welcome new students entering graduate studies at Mae Fah Luang University, acquaint you with the university's departments, and provide valuable information about the rules and regulations pertaining to your graduate studies to help you plan your academic journey effectively. Let's kick off by delving into the essence of Mae Fah Luang University. To give you a comprehensive glimpse, we have prepared a video that introduces the vibrant essence of our esteemed institution.
Mae Fah Luang University celebrates the 24th anniversary of its establishment. From the first step, Mae Fah Luang University successfully retains its core philosophy following the Princess Mother's aspiration, restore forests and develop people. This has driven the university to reach the goal of being an intellectual dependency for the society. Over the years, Mae Fah Luang University has fulfilled its mission of becoming a leading higher education institution. The university has been developing quality human resources in accordance with the manpower needs of the country. Among the disruptive changes of the world, Mae Fah Luang University has been producing academic excellence researches and innovations, responding to Thailand's Sustainable Development Plan. The university was once only a wasteland, yet it has been completely transformed into a university in the park, with a fertile green forest providing suitable environment for living and learning. From its inaugural class of 62 students in 1998, the number of students have been increasing yearly from around the world. The university has now produced more than 35,000 graduates to serve both Thai and global societies. Due to its outstanding development, Mae Fah Luang University has been internationally recognized as the best university in Thailand for three consecutive years in the Times Higher Education World University Rankings. Mae Fah Luang University offers 15 schools covering specific clusters, science and technology cluster, social science and humanities cluster, and health sciences cluster. A wide range of courses are standardized and recognized throughout the country and at international level, valuing Mae Fa Loong University graduates as quality world citizens. Mae Fa Loong University uses English as a medium of instruction in the majority of courses, accordingly with Chinese and other foreign languages. To meet the needs of learners and the labor market, various fresh integrated programs have been launched. Mae Fa Loong University has established the MFU Academy, promoting opportunity for self-improvement beyond classrooms to public learners. To meet the needs of lifelong learning, the Academy thus provides various short courses to public learners with a support system towards certificate programs which can be accessed through various channels. Mae Fa Loong University has a strong mission to continually generate high-quality research and innovations, which play a vital social role and respond to an identified need of the country. Mae Fa Loong University is one of the 13 universities in the Reinventing University System project, with a strategic focus on the global and frontier research. Mae Fa Loong University has published outstanding research studies in various fields, especially research on fungi, cosmetic sciences, agriculture, and food and material sciences. As an intellectual dependency for society, transferring knowledge, technology, and innovations to different sectors is one of the main missions of Mae Fa Loong University. We have relentlessly pursued a multifaceted mission to be successful as the leading university in ASEAN with international recognition. Mae Fa Loong University.
Now, let's turn our attention to the highlight of the day, the opening ceremony of the new graduate student orientation for the academic year 2023. We are graced with the presence of distinguished speakers, Assistant Professor Dr. Matima Narodison, the President of Mae Fa Loong University, who will present a welcoming address, and Assistant Professor Dr. Panupong Chaiwood, the Vice President, who will conduct the opening ceremony. Please welcome Assistant Professor Dr. Panupong Chaiwood to address us with the opening remarks.
Thank you very much. President of Mae Fa Loong University, Assistant Professor Dr. Matima Narodison, Deans, Lecturer, and new graduate students, good morning, everyone. On behalf of the Office of the Postgraduate Studies, I would like to express my appreciation to the President of Mae Fa Loong University, Dr. Matima Narodison, for presiding over the opening ceremony of the orientation for new graduate students in academic year 2023 today. The orientation is held to introduce the student to know the university, service division, teaching and learning approaches, academic services and resources, as well as the rules and regulations related to the postgraduate study, which will help them develop their educational plans and achieve their academic schedule time within schedule time. With this report, I would like to invite the President of Mae Fa Loong University, Assistant Professor Dr. Matima Narodison, to deliver welcome address and give valuable advice to all of you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Vice President. Assistant Professor Dr. Panupong Jaiwut. Thank you. Deans, executives, lecturer, and new postgraduate student of Mae Fan Lung University, and a very good morning to all of you who are online and also in Bangkok at the School of the Anti-Aging. It's give me a great pleasure today to preside over the new postgraduate student orientations for academic year 2023 today, and have the opportunity to meet all of you here at Mae Fan Lung University. I am so proud and highly admire you all for your enthusiasm and decision made for continuing your learning at Mae Fan Lung University. The postgraduate life may be different from what you have experienced before. Your passions and hard work will definitely help you overcome all the obstacles and lead to the achievement as the holder of master degree and postdoctoral degree. And that meaningful success will indeed make yourself proud. It has been 20 years since Mae Fan Lung University has offered a graduate program in, which is in academic year 2002. All of qualified graduates have always built a good reputations and contribute to societies as a whole. From now on, I hope that you will start to explore, develop ideas, expand your knowledge, and apply the knowledge acquired throughout your study at MFU to benefit your personal development. Nevertheless, you will become a graduate and possess virtues, knowledge, collaboration skills, and ability to apply technological competencies properly and effectively. Once again, on behalf of Mae Fan Lung University, I would like to extend a very warm welcome to all of you to be part of Mae Fan Lung University family. Especially, I would like to extremely delight for your academic achievement and be so proud to see you all in Mae Fan Lung University grown in the near future. Be happy, be success at MFU. And now, with this address, I would like to declare this new postgraduate student orientations for the academic year 2023 officially open. Thank you very much.
Our heartfelt gratitude to Vice President, Assistant Professor Dr. Panupong Jaiwut for delivering the opening ceremony report, and to President Assistant Professor Dr. Majima Saranarayson for her warm welcome and insightful speech to our new graduate students. I'd also like to extend our gratitude to the deans and all the esteemed members of the different faculties who have joined us today. Before we proceed, let's capture this moment by turning on our camera for a group photo. Please, everyone, I would like to request you to turn on the camera.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, smile. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, everyone. Hope you enjoy the day today.
Next, we are privileged to have a representative from the Office of Postgraduate Studies, Ms. Onanong Kelmani, who will provide insights into the rules, regulations, and the postgraduate studies process. Please welcome.
Okay, good morning, everyone. I'm a representative of Office of the Postgraduate Study. My name is Onanong Kelmani. Today, I will be giving you with information pertaining to rules and regulations and the processing of postgraduate study. Okay, let's start with the program structure. Okay, for the master degree program, consists of three main plans. Plan A1 focuses on research only. You need to take at least 36 credits for the thesis. And plan A2 focuses on research and coursework. You need to take at least 12 credits for the thesis and 12 credits for the coursework. Most of all, shouldn't be less than 36 credits. For plan B, focus on coursework and to do independent study. You need to take between 3 to 6 credits only. And the maximum study period for the master degree is 4 years from the first semester. For the doctoral program structure, consists of two types. Type 1, focus on research only, divided into two types. Plan 1.1, for students who have a master's degree, you need to do a dissertation not greater than 48 credits in a maximum study period of 5 academic years. Plan 1.2, for students who have bachelor degree, you need to do a dissertation not less than 72 credits in a maximum study period of 7 academic years. For type 2, focus on research and coursework, divided into two types. 2.1, for students who have a master's degree, you need to do a dissertation not less than 36 credits and coursework not less than 12 credits in a maximum study period of 5 academic years. And plan 2.2, for students who have a bachelor's degree, you need to do a dissertation not less than 48 credits and coursework not less than 24 credits in a maximum study period of 7 academic years. And now look at the eight step guide to graduate. For step one, you should know about rules and regulation and announcement which relate with our postgraduate study. Please visit postgrad website for more detail. Step 2. You must register the course followed by your study plan and pay the tuition fee every semester within the time limit required by the university. You can look for academic calendar on the PostGAP website or REG system. Master student in plan A2 and plan B and PhD in plan 2.1 and 2.2. You must have a GPAT not less than 3. In case you have GPAT not less than 3 in 2 consecutive semesters, your status will be changed. Step 3. Qualifying examination and English proficiency test. For a PhD student, must take the first qualifying examination within 4 semesters. And you must pass the exam within 6 semesters. If you cannot do, your status will be terminated. And you can request to take the exam in twice time. If you not pass, your status will be terminated. The school will be arranged the exam at least one per semester, and they will be announced to you. For English proficiency test, a PhD student must have English proficiency test score for admission follow as in the chart. Please look carefully. This score for PhD applicant and for master degree applicant in case any program has specified. If you don't have any result or have result not meet the university requirement, you must resubmit the result within the first semester or you can take a course that provided by the university academic English for Graduate Study 1 and pass the course within the first semester or so. For every postgraduate student must pass the English proficiency test before requesting to take the different exam and graduate as required by the university. This chart shows the English test score for postgraduate student to complete graduate study. Please look carefully. The results are valid for only 2 years from the submission date, and the document need to be submitted to the postgraduate office. And we have choice to you also. That is MFUTEP exam. The MFUTEP exam will be arranged by the School of Liberal Arts. It is set 3 times per academic year, and the days of the test will be announced on postgraduate's website. The MFUTEP exam will be arranged in October, March, and July. The test fee is 1,000 baht per term. Or you can take the English course. For doctoral degree student may take a course academic English for Graduate Study 2, and master degree student may take a course English academic. Academic English for Graduate Study 1. The registration fee is 3,000 baht per term. For step 4, proposal examination. You must pass ethic training or pass an ethic course before you requesting the proposal examination. Master degree student must pass the proposal examination within 4 semesters. And PhD student must pass the exam within 6 semesters. If you don't pass the proposal examination within the time limit, you say that will be terminated. Step 5, comprehensive examination. This for master student in Plan B. You must pass the comprehensive examination before requesting the independent study defense. You must register for all required courses and have the curriculum GPAC not less than 3, and you can request to take exam in 2 times. If you not pass, you say that will be terminated. The school will arrange the exam at least once per semester, and they will be assigned to you. Step 6, publication. You must publish your research at the part of your thesis. Student in master degree program must pass the publish at least 1 research article. For Plan A1, must publish or accept a research article in international journal or journal classified in TCI Group 1 or 2. Plan A2, must publish or accept a research article in international journal or journal classified in TCI Group 1 or 2, or present a paper at national or international conference. For Plan B, you have 4 choices to publish your research article. Once published or accept in international or in the national journal, or to publish the journal classified in TCI Group 1 or 2, and 3, present at the paper at national or international conference, or 4, review by at least 3 specialists before published on the website. Student in the PhD program, type 1.1 and 1.2, you must publish your research at least 2 research article. 1 research article must publish or accept in international journal and one research article is published in international journal or the journal classified in TCI group 1 or 2. For PhD type 2.1 and 2.2, for the field of science and technology and health science, at least one research article is published or accepted in an international journal. For the field humanity and social science, at least one research article is published or accepted in international journal or a journal classified in TCI group 2 or 1 or 2. In the publication, the student name must be the first author. The names of the advisor should be specified as a co-author or a corresponding author. And the affiliation must be Mae Fa Luang University. Step 7, defense examination. You can request to take the defense exam after you pass the proposal exam older than 90 days for the master student plan A2, A1, A2, and PhD student. For the master student plan B, you can request to take the defense exam after you pass the proposal exam older than 45 days. Before your request, you must have an English proficiency test score and have a presentation check yourself. PhD student type 2.1 and 2.2 and master student plan A2 and plan B must complete all course defined in the curriculum and have a GPAT not less than 3. You can request to take the exam in twice time. If you not pass, your setup will be terminated. If your plagiarism academic work create false information and not doing research on your own, your setup will be terminated. This one is a website, Turn It In. It's for check plagiarism. You can access this. You can scan this QR code to access this website. After you pass the recent exam and must revise your thesis, follow the comments of your committee. You must be done within 90 days for a master degree student. Plan A1, A2, and PhD student. And the master degree plan B, you must be done within 60 days after the defense exam date. If you cannot submit the revised paper within the time limit, the result of the defense examination is for fail. You can request to take exam in twice time. If you not pass, your status will be terminated. For format checking and submit a copied book. After completing your thesis, follow the committee comment. You must submit the complete of the thesis in a correct format to Office of the Postgraduate Study to check the format within the time limit. 90 days after the defense exam date for a master degree student, plan A1, A2, and PhD student. And 90 days after the defense exam date for master degree plan B. Periods of format checking. For independent study, the committee will check the format within 7 days. And for dissertation and thesis, the first time within 7 days. If not passed, second time within 4 days. For time counting, if you submit in the morning from 8 o'clock to 12 o'clock in the noon, it will be counting that date as the first day. But if you submit in the afternoon from 1 p.m. to 4 p.m., it would be counting and the next day as the first day. After you completing the format checking, you must submit a complete file in the system. Please upload complete thesis file on electronic thesis archive system for a file in PDF file. Except abstract file will be submitted in Word file and PDF file. And then send the document to Office of the Postgraduate Study consists of DTC 12 form. You can be download this form from that MIS system. And approval page will be having all committee signature and the largest book checking format form. You should plan to submit the complete of this by the in the current academic calendar later. Okay, we have finished in the part of a step to graduate and let you know about more information. In case leave of absence, if you would like to request to leave of absence, you must study at least one semester and have a GPAT not less than 3. You can request to leave of absence only for one semester. If you would like to extend the leave, you must submit a new request. However, your leave period will be counted as a part of the study period. And please remind that the master degree shouldn't leave of absence in the fourth semester if you not pass the proposal examination, and PhD student shouldn't leave of the absence in fourth semester if you haven't taken the first term of qualifying examination, and you haven't passed the qualifying examination and proposal examination in the sixth semester, because your CSAT will be terminated. The university has support then for the postgraduate student. There are theses and dissertation support then and research published presentation or publication grants. The list for the grants depend on your degree and your study plan. You can search for more information in postgraduate website. We have four systems to serve the student. The first one is the GRASP MIS system. This one is used for managing information about research study, such as advisor appointments, request the proposal examination, defend examination, and downloading the form. You can access this system by use username and password. This is the same as the REG system. The second one is the classroom and meeting room. This system used for book the lecture room. And the third one is ethic learning online system. It's used for studying the introductory ethic course. You can learn the lesson and take the test by yourself anywhere, anytime that you want. And the last one is electronic thesis archive system. This one is used for submit your complete of thesis file. Okay, we have finished our session. Do you have any question? If you would like to for more information, please follow our Facebook fan page and explain at line official account. You can scan this QR code. Okay.
So if you have questions, please feel free to ask by now or you can ask later. I mean, you can leave your message in the chat box.
Okay. Today, thank you for your attention, ค่ะ. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Onanong Gelmani, for your illuminating presentation on the postgraduate studies process. Moving on, we have an introduction to the services offered by the Registrar Division. Please welcome Ms. Nan Wenyo from the Registrar Division.
Good morning, everyone. I am from Registrar Division from Mei Fa Long University. Today, I will introduce about our department, what we present for. So right now, I will show you a video about the Registrar Division. Let's start with the video.
ไปรู้จักส่วนทะเบียนและประมวลผลทะเบียนการศึกษาให้บริการทางด้านของการลงทะเบียนเช่นงานแจ้งความประสงค์ขอลงทะเบียนเรียนล่วงหน้างานลงทะเบียนเรียนปกติลงทะเบียนเรียนล่าช้าเพิ่มลดรายวิชาหรือถอนรายวิชาอีกทั้งยังมีงานลงทะเบียนเรียนสอบวัดความรู้ก่อนสำเร็จการศึกษาลาพักการศึกษาขอกลับเข้าศึกษางานรักษาสถานภาพการเป็นนักศึกษาขอคืนสถานภาพการเป็นนักศึกษางานลาออกจากการเป็นนักศึกษางานเทียบโอนรายวิชางานบันทึกอาจารย์ที่ปรึกษาและงานให้บริการจองห้องเรียนฝ่ายประมวลผลการศึกษาและจัดสอบงานจัดทำสำเนาข้อสอบงานจัดสอบงานจำแนกสภาพนักศึกษาที่มีสภาพวิทยาทัณฑ์งานจัดทำคำสั่งพ้นสภาพนักศึกษาเพราะผลการศึกษาต่ำกว่าเกณฑ์และงานประมวลผลการศึกษาฝ่ายบริการการศึกษาและจัดการทั่วไปบริการทางด้านการศึกษาปฏิทินการศึกษางานระเบียนประวัตินักศึกษางานขึ้นทะเบียนนักศึกษาใหม่งานประชาสัมพันธ์ทางการศึกษางานบันทึกระเบียนประวัติงานตรวจสอบคุณวุฒินักศึกษาใหม่ฝ่ายรับนักศึกษางานรับสมัครและคัดเลือกนักศึกษาระดับประกาศนียบัตรปริญญาตรีบัณฑิตศึกษางานประสานงานรับนักศึกษาต่างชาติงานกำหนดรหัสประจำตัวนักศึกษาฝ่ายระเบียนการศึกษางานตรวจสอบคุณวุฒิงานย้ายสาขาวิชางานตรวจสอบผู้มีสิทธิสอบวัดความรู้ก่อนสำเร็จการศึกษางานตรวจสอบนักศึกษาที่คาดว่าจะสำเร็จการศึกษางานตรวจสอบการสำเร็จการศึกษางานขอสำเร็จการศึกษางานเหรียญรางวัลเกียรติยศผลการเรียนดีเด่นงานจัดทำใบปริญญาบัตรงานพิธีพระราชทานปริญญาบัตรนอกจากนี้ยังมี M4U เพื่อให้บริการแบบ One Stop Service ซึ่งให้บริการด้านงานเอกสารสำหรับนักศึกษาปัจจุบันการขอหนังสือสำคัญทางการศึกษาและยังให้บริการทางด้านข้อมูลนักศึกษาและนี่คืองานที่รับผิดชอบทั้งหมดของส่วนทะเบียนและประมวลผลมหาวิทยาลัยแม่ฟ้าหลวง
Create a professional logo that best reflects your brand. Just go to Wix Logo Maker.
Okay, so right now, after video, we'll go to the presentation about our department.
The staff to correct is for you. Next one, education record sections. They provide you an academic document, which is a transcript and student certificate. You can request the website through the online, and they will check the graduation, check the courses that you have completed or not before you graduate. Okay, the next one is about calendar. We want you to know and focus about the calendar. We have the academic calendar and registration calendar is all on our website. You guys can take a look and keep in touch with the schedule. The next one, and about the payment. We all of the students need to complete the payment before the semester starts. So about the payment, we want you to know that we have format option for the payment. We have most of you will be scanned, and if you don't have a bank account, you can bring the receipt and complete the payment at the bank. I will show you the letter for the example to complete the payment. And the next one here is the to request the academic document on our REG website. Of course, I will show you the example for requiring the document on the website. Okay, before we leave, I will show you about the requirement from the doc request the academy document from our REG website. Okay, if you come to the webs, if you come to the Google, you can type reg.mfu and press the search bar. You will see the REG website showing on. So right now here is the, you will see the academy document over here. You can choose to requirement the document. And here is, let me show you example. Type your student ID and also the password from the REG. Okay, after you log in, you'll see the screen over here, and you just need to require a new document. Did you see the green bar over here? You just press here, and they have a four option for you. You can take by yourself, or you can ask your friend to take for you, and you can ask the staff to send you by process, or you can download by PDF file. Let me show you. We take by ourselves, and we need to write a reason why we require the document. and write down your phone number and your email. You can put your Barcelona email or your London email. Okay, after you complete all the requirement here,
มันต้องกดปุ่มข้างล่างมันจะเลื่อนลงมันจะมีปุ่มค่ะมันจะมีต้อง
ยอกยอกอ๋อโอเค
ได้ไม่ได้
ได้ค่ะได้ค่ะ
เออต้องเลื่อนลง
ใช่ค่ะเลื่อนลงแล้วก็โยกโยกตรงไหนนะโอเคโอเค after you complete all the blank and you just plus the next step and it will ask it will be showing at document list over here. You can choose example like to do the visa. You need to take a certificate of student status by English versions and okay, save. And next one is you need to choose a transcript for English versions. And of course, you need to press a save icon. And after that, press next again. And next again, here is they ask you to complete the email. You can put your email, the personal email or your London email. Okay, and press the next. Now you can complete the payment, pay the fee. So it will be a lot of options like I mentioned before. Have for mention, you can complete with 4 options. If you want to pay by scan the QR code, you need to press here again, one more. So you will see your name over here. And complete the payment. After you complete the payment, you can take the document right away. Okay, next one is about the payment for the tuition fee. So after we log in, okay. After you log in, it will be showing your picture over here. So let me show you by the view of the student. Okay. If you need to complete the payment, example, you need to come here or and you'll see the payment here. If you need to complete the payment will show here. Like you just press the payment over here and complete the payment. Okay, so here is our presentations have and so thank you for your attention.
Our thanks to Ms. Nguyen for introducing the valuable services of the Registrar Division. Now, let's delve into the services provided by the Center for Library and Educational Media. Joining us are Ms. Nachayada Temru and Ms. Titipon Tengkuha. Please welcome.
Okay. Good morning, everybody. My name is Nashiyada. I'm a librarian. Today, I will introduce you about MFU Library. I have divided the topic into three sections. First, about library resources. Second, library service. And the last, searching for academic resources. If you have any question, please feel to ask me during my presentation, or you keep them for our Q&A section. Okay, thus, before you borrow books or library resources, I would like to suggest you register for library membership. You can scan this QR code and log in with your IET account and update your information. And we provide a try of information, including books, journals, and databases. Okay, next, I would like to show you about the library website, and you can access library resources through the library website. You can log in World Wide Web, library.mfu.ac.th. And I recommend you about when you out of campus and or you using your internet, I would like to suggest about EasyProxy. You must log in EasyProxy first. Okay. That you see, EasyProxy is a web browser server to provide access to the library online subscription databases for MFU students. And you can log in. You can log in with your IET account. But if you are using the university network, you don't have to log in with this. Okay. And back to the homepage. Moreover, we provide resource support and reference service in the middle of the page. For example, TurnItIn is a web-based service to check the plagiarism of your paper, and Mendeley is the resource support to help you with the citation, and reading guide is the recommend of the book divided by the school. And back to the homepage. If you find out that there is no books or resource that you need, I will introduce you two options. The first option is to suggest resources to us. The library will cooperate with your school to consider the resource if they are ready needed. And the second, back to the homepage, the second is to borrow it from our library partner. The service is called Interlibrary Loan, or ILL. So don't worry if you don't have find the resources, we will find a new way together. And back to the homepage again. If you want to see about subscription databases, you can up to the homepage and click the menu of databases. It will show all databases that we provide for you. And go to the homepage. I want to recommend you about journal menu. Journal menu, you can select the static field and and then select study field first and then select the school that you want. You can see all the journal about your school. Okay. So next section, คุณทิติพร will interview you about searching library resources.
Okay, last but not least, let's move to the part of searching for academic resources. And the service, I will start with the library website. You can switch. You can switch the language to English on the top right of the screen. The library website will be the portal for searching all of the printed and electronic resources. And now we will have a look at a single search engine that combines all kinds of search. You can search for books, journal, and databases here. It will be on the right hand side on the website of the library. The single search will be here. And when you enter the search term, you can select the search category from keyword, title, and also the author. If you select the keyword, it look for you for the word anywhere in the record. And when you select the title, the word will be appear for the part of the article's title. And if you select for the author, it search for the article's author. And when you already enter the search term and you click the search right here, it will appear to you like this. This is called a single search result page. It is divided into three sections. On your left hand side, you will see the limiters that help you narrow your search result, and you can select the limiters to refine the search to full text, range of the publication date and sort type, and etc. And in the middle of the screen, you will see the search result, and on your right hand side, you will see the customized section of each library. So now let's look deeper to the refine result. It is also divided into three sections. Also, the first section is that what we call current search detail. The current search detail keeps track of your search term, search option, and also the facet that you apply to your search. The next section is that the limit of your results. You can apply the limiters such as full text and publication date. Select any of the limiters that display and then just click update. The result list will be revised. And the last section is that what we call the facets, which you can narrow by sort type, subject, and publication, and etc. So after you already apply all the limiters, it will show you like this. It is to view the search result. This is the search result page. You can choose whatever resources that you want. Now let's look at the red letter title. This one we call the title links to look more for the bibliography description. And also you see the number two right here, right? it is to view the full text. But right now, I want you to see what happens if I click on the title link here. It will show you about three things. Let's start with the first one in the middle here. It will be the detailed records that may include a summary or an abstract. And on your left-hand side, we will see the full text, if is it available. And on your right-hand side, it will be the managed tools that are available for you to select. For example, if you pin this full text, you can click the pin. And you can also email to whoever you want. And also you can even open it by Google Drive or anything on this right hand side. You can choose whatever you want. So the other thing that I mentioned is to click to see the full text. You can click to see the full text on this page and also in the left hand side also. So if we click into the red little title link, you will see this page is what we call the bibliography description page. You will see the abstract here and also the full text on your left hand side. So that was all our single search engine. So right now I want to recommend you that the library always manage and arranges the library training on how to use the research support tools. If you want to know anything in depth, you can check it out at our website and also our Facebook page. The topic, the date, and the place will also be updated monthly. You can check it on our website. And if there is no topic that you are interested in, don't worry about that, because we also have the training on request. This one you can request for the topic that you want to know in depth. And also, if you want to learn something basic, I mean, for example, on how to seek information or on how to find the books, you can also go to our website. We also offer the library tutorials, which is the video that describe any basic thing about the library. This one you can also go to the library website, and this video are attached on the website. You can learn about it anywhere and anytime. So that's it, our presentation today. Does anyone have any questions so far? You can type your question on the chat. So thank you for joining us today. If you have any question in the future, you are very welcome to ask our librarian via our website, our line, and our email, and also our Facebook page. We are always here with you. So thank you for today.
Sorry for the inconvenience. Please wait for a moment, for we are having technical issues. If you have any questions for now, you can type down in the chat box. Okay, good morning, everyone. We are the staff from the Global Relations Division. Today, we are bringing you two topics. The first one is immigration rules, and the second one is about the health insurance. Let's begin with the immigration rules first. So today's topic, we will present three topics. The first one is the visa and passport and the shuttle bus to the immigration office. The student visa is called non-ED visa. I believe everyone have already got the visa already. And please be careful that the student visa is a single entry visa. It means when you leave in Thailand without your entry permit, your student visa will expire immediately. And the first student visa takes 3 months period of validity. So about 3 months left, you have to extend your visa into a 1 year visa. And then now you can see in the screen, there is a visa stamp. The first one, the red one, is your arrival date. And the blue one is your visa expiration date. You have to check your visa expiration date frequently. And please don't confuse about the sticker visa in the left, the bottom of the left. Here is an example of sticker visa, but it's not your current visa stamp. The current visa stamp will show you your visa expiration date, so it's very important for the visa extension. About the visa information, you can search on the Google, the Global Relations Divisions, and find the service. There's a student visa. You can click in there and you can find some useful information relating with your student visa and other your passport or other information that you can find in here, the student visa. And we want to introduce our all-in-one request system. In all-in-one request, you can request for the visa extension and the new visa application, also the visa cancellation. And for some students, you may consider to renew your passport. You also can request for the recommendation letter for passport renewal. And when you use the all-in-one request, please use your London email to log in with and upload your personal information. For visa extensions, you have to prepare the student certificate and transcript. But since this is the first semester of your study in MFU, so the first semester, when you do the visa extension, you don't need to submit the transcript. So only certificate of student status is okay. After you upload these documents in all-in-one system, we will offer you the recommendation letter for visa extensions. This letter is issued by GRD, which means with the Global Relations Division, we will issue your recommendation letter, and we will send the letter to Vice President to leave her signature. After that, we will inform you your document is ready. You can go to the M4U Center to get your document, the recommendation letter, and it would be great for you if you can begin to do the visa extension 45 days before your visa expiration. Because if your visa expired, you will be fined 500 baht per day. Since you are postgraduate student, normally, the master degree has a 2 years program or 3 years program, but some students might study over plane. So when you do the visa extension, you have to apply for the, you have asked for the recommendation letter from your advisor to specify when you will finish your program. After that, we will state the date in the recommendation letter for visa extension. You can scan the QR code to download the recommendation letter to your advisor. And as I said earlier, your student visa is single entry. So before you leave Thailand, you go to another country or back home, you must apply for the re-entry permit. You can apply for this re-entry permit at the international airport or the immigration office. There is two types of a re-entry permit. The first one is the single entry, costs 1,000 baht. And another one is multiple entry, cost 3,800 baht. In the in this screen, you can see the example of re-entry permit. And the re-entry permit has the same validation with your student visa, which means when your student visa expired, the re-entry permit also expired. So you have to extend your visa first, extend your visa to 1 year's visa. After that, apply for the re-entry permit. So your re-entry permit also contains 1 year's valid validations. And if you leave Thailand without a re-entry permit, your student visa will expire immediately. So it's very important for you. But unfortunately, if you forget to apply for the re-entry permit, your student visa expires. So you might consider to apply for a new student visa to come to university. For apply for the new student visa, you also have to submit your transcript and certificate of student status. After that, send them to the all-in-one system. Around 3 working days, we will offer you the recommendation letter for visa applications and also the copy of ID card from the vice president and the embassy certification for visa applications. This is for visa cancellation when you graduate from the university or you just want to transfer your school from MFU to another university. You have to apply for the visa cancellation. You have to submit your documents, your passport and your current visa stamp to send to us, and we will offer you the recommendation letter for visa cancellation. Also, if you want to work in Thailand in the future, you also have to cancel your current student visa. And when you take the recommendation letter for visa cancellation, you have to check the visa cancellation date with the staff. They will tell you when your visa will expire. And for this letter, you have to apply for it 14 days before you're leaving Thailand. And this one is for 90-day reports. You have to report your current status to immigration office every 90 days. And you can do it 15 days before, but not less than 7 days after due date. Actually, the 90-day report is very easy. You can just do it in online. Just log into the Thai Immigration Office website and you can find it there. There is a application for 90-day reports. You can just do it in online. It takes around 5 to 10 minutes. You have to do it every 90 days. Otherwise, you will be fined 2,000 baht from the Immigration Office. And for Myanmar students, some of you might consider to renew your passport. And it's quite difficult for Myanmar students. So when you choose, when you decided to apply for the new passport, you have to request for the recommendation letter from the university. We will offer you the recommendation letter for you to renew your passport. But for another country students, you can contact the embassy or counselor in Thailand directly. They will help you to renew your passport. So normally, this document is for Myanmar students only. And after you getting a new passport, the first thing you have to do is transfer your student visa from the old passport to your current new passport. After that, contact registration divisions to renew your passport information. Here, we want to show the process of making a recommendation letter. Some of you might think that making a document is very easy, it can be done in one day, but actually it's very difficult and there's so many processes to making a document. Normally, it takes 3 to 5 working days. You can see the process in the screen. So normally, we will receive your request and we will send your, we are making the documents and then send to the head of the Global Relations Division to check and sign. After that, we have to send to the Vice President and the Secretary of the Vice President also have to check the documents again. If all documents is correct, we will ask the Vice President to sign your letter. After that, we will send email to inform you, and then you can come to the M4U Center to take the documents. It do takes a long time. So you have to request for the recommendation letter 45 days before your visa expires. And this is for students from the School of Anti-Aging and Regenerative Medicine. Because your school is in Bangkok, not in the main campus. So every time when you do the visa extension, you have to submit your documents 45 days before your visa expires. Because we also have to send your documents from Chiang Rai to Bangkok, which is takes many times. And you do check your visa stamp frequently, because this year some students from the School of Anti-Aging, they forget the visa expiration date. So when their visa expired, they came to us to request for the visa cancellation, visa extensions, but it's too late. They have to be fined 500 baht per day. And also for School of Anti-Aging and Regenerative Medicine, you can contact people and the people. They will send some useful information about the visa extensions to you. And we also, when your document is ready, we will send the document to Mr. People or people, and they will send the document to you again. And this is for M4U Center. M4U Center is in main campus in Chiang Rai. So when your document is ready, we will send an email to inform you to come to the M4U Center, count one or count two, to get your document, to get your recommendation letter back. But and if you have some problem relating with your visa or the passport, you also can come to there to contact us. The M4U Center will open on every working days. So this means in weekends or public holiday, the office soon will be closed. And this one is for free shuttle bus to immigration office. Every month we offer the shuttle bus to immigration office, but you have to book the seat 3 working days in advance. The bus stop is in front of the M Square. Also, this service is for main campus students only. So it means if you are student from the School of Anti-Aging, you have to go to immigration office by yourself. And if there are any questions about your visa or your passport, you can ask us, or you can just send email to mfuglobal@mfu.ac.th to find some information relating with your passport or your visa. Yes, you can apply for the visa extension and the re-entry permit at the same time, but we recommend to apply for the visa extension first and then apply for the re-entry permit.
Some student asking, can we apply visa extension and re-entry permit at the same time? Okay. Which? Oh, they need information regarding certain costs. For the student who asking for the accommodation information, I am unsure that you are studying in Bangkok or in Chiang Rai campus. Bangkok. So can you leave your email account on this chat box? Then I will find out or send to the staff in Bangkok to reply you soon, please. Next question, can you
Yes, for the next report, you can do it with the visa extensions. So our staff will show you the information about the student insurance, health insurance.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Jawaha Pumpun. I'm from the Global Relations Division, and I'm taking care of the insurance for international students. Okay, today I'm going to give you the a brief information about the insurance information. Okay, this is the sample of the insurance card. At the beginning of the semester, we will provide or prepare the insurance for all international students. And for this semester, the insurance card have been submitted to, the requirement from us have been submitted to the insurance company already, and the card is on process. So once it's ready, we will send an email to notify all of you to take the insurance at M4U Center. For those who studying in Bangkok, we're gonna send the insurance card to the school, and then you can contact the school staff and take it. What we would like to recommend all of you is to have the insurance on hand at all times. The insurance we prepare for the international student this year, it's cover COVID-19 treatment as well. So you can use this insurance card in case of both accidents and health units and COVID-19 too. Okay, what it in card? In the insurance card, you will see that there is the policy number of the insurance, period of the insurance, and the card they stated the brief coverage of the insurance as well, and the number of hotline center. In this card, in this sample card, I have already stated the requirement document in case of you want to apply for medical fee refund. So this is the list of the document we need. And I also put the QR code on this picture as well. If you scan this QR code and if you use Lamdon email, you will get the information about the insurance. What is in the Google Drive? Name list of the hospital in contract with this company. So wherever you are in Thailand, there's the hospital listed in contact with insurance, Thevet insurance. So you can check, for example, if you are in Bangkok, you can check which hospital you can go, or which hospital is close to your area, you can choose from the list. And I also put the maximum coverage amount of each cases which are covered by this insurance in the Google Drive as well. So you can check it out anytime. Apart from those information, I put the general exclusion condition and termination condition as well. So you can check anytime which case you can apply for the refund or which case you cannot get the refund. And here is the list of documents that we require you in case that you have to pay for your medical fee first, and you have to apply the refund from us. This is the list of document required. Original receipt, doctor certificate. These two documents, we need the original one. This one, it's your copy of passport and a copy of your book bank account. Your book bank account must be a Thai bank account. Send those required documents to me via post. Here is the information of address. And if you need more information about the insurance, here is my contact information. For students who are studying on campus, you can come and talk with us at M4U Center. For students who study in Bangkok, please don't hesitate to send an email. And one more time, for students who study in Bangkok, we really need the original document to you, so you guys have to send the required document to post to my office. Okay, and one important thing is some of the students have to study over the study plan or some of you may take a break of the semester, and whenever you return to enroll as a student again, please don't forget to inform us about your period of insurance, because we may have to apply for you with the insurance company, because your study plan will change, so it will be done in person, one by one. Okay, for the information about this academic year, we have already put it in the Google Drive, so you can get and check it anytime. Any questions about the insurance? For those who are asking for the student ID card, student ID card processed by Bangkok Bank, and once it's ready, I think the registration division will send an email to you, and then you may have to get it at the Bangkok Bank. For the student who study in Bangkok, I think the registration division will collect it and send it to your school in Bangkok, then you can get it later. Okay.
Special thanks to Mr. Siu Kung Jiang and Ms. Yawapa Prampum for the insightful presentation on the services provided by the Global Relations Division. With these informative sessions, the morning segment of the new graduate student orientation for the academic year 2023 draws to a close. In the afternoon, we have planned research ethics training in both Thai and English lecture rooms, where esteemed lecturers will guide you through the essentials. Thai lecture by Assistant Professor Dr. Somphorn Thantipasikun, lecturer from School of Nursing, and member of Human Research Ethics Committee of Mae Fah Luang University, and English Room by Associate Professor Dr. Daruni Watanasiriwit, lecturer from School of Science. It is important to note that passing the research ethics training is a prerequisite for the proposal exam. To register, simply scan the QR code on the orientation documents and receive the Zoom meeting link and attendance guidelines via email. As we conclude, we kindly request your feedback on today's event by scanning the QR code on the screen. Your valuable input will aid us in enhancing future orientations. Thank you for your participation, and we wish you a rewarding academic journey ahead. Thank you. Hello everyone, the recorded video of this meeting will be uploaded on the YouTube channel called Office of Postgrad by next week. You can check it out. Thank you.